Hello my dear students, today I am going to start with a new chapter, algebraic expression. You should write this notes in algebraic part. Okay, so first algebraic expression. So what is meant by expression? So you already studied the equation. Equation is, so in the algebraic expression, so this is one equation, isn't it? So all x plus 4 equals to, take anything, 5. Okay, this is an equation. Equation means, equation contains equal sign. So here equal sign is there, isn't it? So this we call it as equation. Okay, so this is an equation. So what is mean by expression? So expression means this term, x plus 4, only this term is an expression. Algebraic expression means the expression contains algebraic terms. Algebraic terms means these are the letters, isn't it? In the algebraic part or algebra, so we will use the letters, isn't it? So this is an algebraic expression. So equation means this contains equal sign. In that, this part is called as an expression. Otherwise, take anything, 2x plus 5, 3y plus 7, or 8z plus 2. So this is called as an expression. Expression contains, these are the variables. Okay, I will explain later. So this expression contains terms. Terms, factors, variables, more than that. Okay, so this we call it as an expression. So these are expression. So these are expressions. Okay, so next, so this is expression. In that expression, so I will take 2x 5 equals to, or 5y plus 3 equals to, this is an expression, isn't it? So first, this is an expression. So next, terms. Next, the word terms. So this is a one term, okay? This is one term, 2x. Like that, 5y, this is another term. 3, another term. So here, 2x is another term, y is another term. In this expression, there are two terms of it. This is one term, complete one term. And this is another term. Tell me this one. So total how many terms are there here? Total 3 terms. This is one term, this is another term, and this one is last term. 1 plus 1 plus 1. Total how many terms are there? 3 terms are there. Okay. Total 3 terms. So this we call it as a terms. Terms contains variables, numbers. Okay. So this is a term. Okay. So it finishes the terms. Next. What you have to show, this is a term. Next, take it as a factor. So you know that factors. So if 4 is there, so what are the factors? You can use that as a 2 into 2, isn't it? So 2 into 2, yes or no? So 2 into 2. So first, this is an expression. So here terms to respective for this expression, terms are 2x, 5y and 3. Okay, so next factors. So you can write 4 as a 2 into 2 or 4 into 1. Like that, how can you write this? 2x. You should write that as a 2x. 2 into x. 2 into x. 2x. It is just a product of these two factors. 2x is a term. So term is a product of its factors. So for 2x, 2 and x are the factors. For 5y. For 5y. 5 and y are the factors. And 3 is as. Okay. So factors for 2x. So how to write it? For 2x, 2 into x. Next, 5.5 and 1.3. So as this, you should write in your data set 3 into 1 or leave it as is for 3. So these are 5 types. Okay. So next, what is this x? In this expression, what is this x? X, we call it as a x. Here y is there, and here x, y, z is there, x square y. So ab is there. So these are, we call it as a variables. What is that? Variables. Variables means it does not contain a constant value. It varies for numbers. So take it as x plus 4. So we have taken x plus 4, isn't it? If you put the value x equals to 1, x equals to 1, what will get the answer? So put 1 plus 4 equals to 5, isn't it? Otherwise, take the value of x. X equals to 2. X equals to 2. So you can take it as a, so don't take it as an expression, just take the expression, don't take the equation. So x value is 1, you will get answer 5. So x value, put the x value to 1 and 2 plus 4, 6. So if you put x value is 3, 3 plus 4, how much? 7. That means it changes for values. X equals to 1, 2, 3. That means it is not a constant value. Variable means it varies. It changes for values. That means variables are the varies. It changes different values. It is not a constant values. All the letters in English alphabet, all the letters are there. That we call it as a variables. So here x is there. So take it 5 m square y. So here m and y are, what are they? Variables. So these are variables. So what is this 5? So in this expression, here 2x is there. Okay, 2x is there. So x is a variable. So what is meant by this one 2? 2. What is this 2? 2 is a constant, isn't it? It never changes. So 2 is constant. If it is constant, that means 2 is a constant. That means it does not change any values. So here x plus 4, there are 2 terms are there. So x plus 4, so there are 2 terms are there. So take another one, 2x plus 5. So this is one term, isn't it? So this is one term. Sorry, 2 terms are there. This is an expression. One term and this is one term. So here 2x you have taken, isn't it? So 2x, here x is variable. X is variable. But here 2 is constant, isn't it? It does not change its value. Because if you put x equals to 1, 2, 3, you should 2 as a constant. That means here 2 is constant. The constant in the term. So this is one term, isn't it? The constant in the term. So this is one term, isn't it? So this is the constant. So constant in the term, we call it as a coefficient. What is that? Coefficient. We call it as a coefficient. What is that? The constant. The constant in the product of variables. So here variable is it and this is constant. So constant means it has a numerical value. Coefficient means numerical value. Numerical value. So this we call it as a constant. Constant. So constant means this is numerical value 3. 3, 4, 8, 12. So many numbers are there. That numbers we call it as a here coefficient. If the that is the product. In the term, 3y square is there, or take another one. 2, oh, sorry, take it another one. 5xy. So this is one term. So term is product of variables and constant is there. So constant, that numerical constant we call it as a coefficient. What is that? Coefficient means the numerical constant. The numerical constant in the term. So this is coefficient. So tell me here, I will give one expression exactly. So how to write variables? So take one expression. So this is an expression. So first, this is an expression. Okay. So next we have to write terms. So next we have to write terms. So what are the terms? 3x square y and another one is 5xy. So these are terms. So next, factors. How to write factors? So factors. First, 3x square y is there. So how to write it? This one. 3 as is here x square. X square means there are 2 x's are there. X and 1. So 3xxy are the factors of 3x square y. So last one, 5xy. So factors for 5xy, 5xy. So here x square is there. How to write x square? X square as a x into x, isn't it? X into x. So like that, 3xxy. So these are factors. So terms finished, factors finished. If you want to write coefficient, so what is the coefficient of x? So here first, if they ask numerical coefficient, write it as 3. Okay, numerical. Numerical coefficient is 3. Okay, otherwise, if they ask coefficient of y, so here coefficient of y in 3x square y in 3x square y is, what is that? Leave this y, remaining term is there, no remaining this term. So that is the coefficient of y. If they ask y, write as the 3x square. Is, what is that answer? 3x square. If they ask numerical coefficient, numerical coefficient is, numerical is number. So here number is 3, isn't it? Numerical coefficient is 3. Here numerical coefficient is 5. If they ask only coefficient of, here 5xy is there. So here coefficient of x is, what is the coefficient of x? Just leave that x, the remaining term is there, that is the coefficient. Coefficient of x is 5, 1. Okay. So first expression, terms, factors, variables, numerical constant, coefficient. I hope you understand the concept of these terms. Next concept is like terms, unlike terms. So we already studied in fractions, like fractions, unlike fractions, like that. Here, like terms, unlike terms. So first see here, 3x, 5x, 8x, minus 15x, otherwise, minus 4y, y square, take it as 4y square, 5y square, 8y square, otherwise 3xy, 5xy, 8xy. So these three part as a like terms. Why? Like terms means that these are the terms, isn't it? First, so the terms, so this is first one, this is second one, and this one is third. So these are like terms. Why? Because it contains the same variable with power. So here variable is x. Whatever be the coefficient, just leave the coefficient. Just check the variables. So here variables are same x and their power. X power is 1. So here x power is 1. So these are like terms. So just check second one. So here variable is y, that is same, and the power y square, power is 2. Here also power is 2. Here power is 2. So these are like terms. Check the third one. So leave the coefficient. Just check the variables. Here x, y is there. What about here x, y? Here also x, y. So these are like terms. Like terms means the terms that contains the same variable with powers. Same variables. Here variables are same, isn't it? So same variable with same powers. It should be same powers. So what is the definition? So definition is like terms. The terms which contain same variables with the same power, with the same power, with the same power. So example, take an example, 5x square y minus 8x square y. Don't look yx square. So both are same one here. X square y is there. X square y is there. Y square. Both are same. Because x power is 2. Here also 2. So these are like terms. Otherwise take it. Total x, 15x, 8x, etc. So these are like terms. So unlike this, variable may be changed or power may be changed. So that are terms are unlike terms. So example, here 3x is there, 5y. So these are unlike terms. Why? Because their variables are changed. So these are unlike terms. So take another one. Can you see these are unlike terms? Yes. First, here variables are same, but what about the powers? Here x power is 2, here x power is 1, x power is 3. So these are unlike terms. So what is the definition of unlike terms? The terms which contain different variables with the different powers. Different variable or different variables. That is the definition of unlike terms.